It's a new day, and today I think I'm going to dive into the evince part of confining the desktop. So let's go to our shell. This isn't it. This seems to be it. So let's just first start by cleaning up some stuff. My login user, clean that, kill the processes. But we have a permission denied. Oh, right. That's because I'm logged in. Yeah. Right. So, and then also run the clear my login user shell script. Okay, and ls all z temp, and then rm. RF 10. Let's just do this stuff here. So we should be clean right now. So evince. Let's just have a look at that package. So now I'm on the host system, and I'll just do a rpm query all evince. So here we have it, less that, and we have some programs here. We have evince d and libexec, and we have user bin evince, evince previewer, and evince thumbnail. Now, and here we have that did. Actual DBus service for evince. Now I'm not sure how that works. Could have a look at it, although it doesn't. These DB service files don't have that much info. Nano. Forgot the slash. So yeah, we really need to take care of that stuff. Evince the. So yeah, I'm not sure how I can actually test that stuff, but let's just at least set it up so that it is set up to be confined properly. So let's get back to my shell. Where am I? This seems to be it here. So let's nano my login user file context file and create a new block here. These are the evince things. Now since evince does that PDF dance, it's probably a good idea to make this as confined as possible. So I'm going to create separate types for each of these components. Evince, and this is going to be evince preview. Evince preview. Okay, let's keep this readable. Preview, just like that. Some then evince thumb. evince thump and evince d. So let at least this stuff is set up properly. And I'm going to just copy over this whole stuff because I can't remember all these types. So and then I'll just take care of that. So we already had some event stuff in our policy module, but just events and not the other events related, at least not that I'm aware of. But we can use these. So for example, here we have events. Then we can basically use, and I'll paste this in temporarily, to events pref events dump and events d events d. And this is a C. It's a bit slow this morning. So yeah, this can be removed right now because we have the names. And then basically start first by just copying over the simple stuff. And yeah, just first do that. And then just basically replace the stuff. So that now we know at least that none of the events is labeled with generic types. And here we have events thump, the thumbnailer. So in Fedora we have one module for all thumbnailers. But yeah, Fedora is a targeted policy. And since my policy is supposed to be at some point considered strict policy, we should basically confine the thumbnailers in their respective domains. Yeah, I'm not sure if that's the right way to put it, but anyways, each thumbnailer should have its own domain, I guess, for now. And then later we could consider merging them. For now, so well, we don't know a lot yet, but at least the files now get labeled with the proper type, so if something runs it, then we should be aware of it, then we are aware of it, and that's a start. So let's just take care of the domain transition of the basically the primary events application. We know that is run by GNOME shell, and probably not only by GNOME shell, but first and foremost by GNOME shell, because you can basically click the events icon in your menu and that'll run it. And that's the way we're going to approach that for now. So let's just create a transition for events. So it's the same deal as with GNOME system monitor, which is also run by the GNOME shell. We're just going to replace the gsysmon stuff, and then we can just basically use that same block of policy. It'll save some time. So when shell runs, evince executable file, then domain transition from shell to evince. And then later we're going to probably add an attribute for all the programs that run evince, because evince is also run from plenty programs. Then we can use the same concept that we used for programs that run Yelp. So it runs Yelp, and then we're going to have a similar attribute, but then it's called runs evince. But we're not at that point yet. So we have the transition set up currently, so let's save and exit this. And let's just make f user share as a Linux dev make file. So it's loading. Let's see what we have here. Yeah, it's loading. Actually, it's not loading. We're going to make it load. SE module E. And then, what is it called? My login user pp. Now it's loading. Take a sip of my coffee in the meanwhile. We need to make sure that we relabel these objects, but we have some issues here. So we have multiple different specifications for evince thumbnailer. Okay, so this is an issue. What I was just saying earlier was that Fedora basically has another implementation of confining the thumbnailers. Now, this is what we're seeing here. So I basically created a label, or created a type for evince thumb exactly for the evince thumbnailer. But actually this path, this file is already labeled with the type thumb exact t. And so we have a conflict. So what this basically means is the following. We're going to remove that one. Evince thumb is out. It's already confined to in some way, not the way I'd like it to be. But yeah, we're not trying to basically break the existing policy. So in the so in that sense, evince thumb. So in that sense, we're just going to ignore it because yeah, Fedora already decided to deal with it in some way. And so we shouldn't break that. So we'll try this again without the evince thumb stuff. So in some ways that is fortunate, because the thumb programs, there are pretty many of them, and shit. Oops, sorry for my bad language, but turns out that evince is also already. That would be not nice. So let's have a look at the host, see if it's me. It could be that it's nah, so nah, this is fine, but for some reason it's broken. Let's see how that works. So let's try that again. So here you have multiple different specifications, and here you have multiple same specifications. So see if that goes again. Oh right, yeah. This it's actually specified two times probably. Yeah. It's two times in the same file context file. Sorry. Yeah, it's still a bit early. So yeah. Evince exact. So here it already is. The evince, and then we're basically doing it again here. So that's a bad idea, of course, because that's multiple same specifications. So let's save and exit. So that is not a good sign for the remainder of the day. Because if we start making mistakes so early in the day, then that usually is a sign that it's not going to go that smoothly. But on the other hand, I just had a late last night, so it could be just that once I truly wake up and finish my coffee that things get better. So yeah, we installed it. We have this transition set up right now, so if I log in and run evince, then it should actually run. So let's just first get status, enforce, and we're enforcing. So let's just set enforce 0 and let's see where that gets us. So here we are at the login screen. Let's just log in there. See if that works. Seems to work. So go to the menu, and then somewhere in here we have evince. At least it's, I suppose so. Office. Here we have the document viewer. This is evince. So now I should be able to run that, or at least we're in permissive mode. So of course I should be, I am able to run it. But it should run with a domain transition. So we should see some rules here. So here we have the document viewer. Now the document viewer has a content, so we need to basically make it a Yelp, a runs Yelp domain. And let's just quit out of that. And let's just do the out search dance MAVCTS, and we're at 10:21 just for good measure. Audit to allow, and then less that stuff because probably might be a lot of stuff there. So let's have a look at what we have. So the transition did work. Let's take a step back and first see if something gets executed, because if anything gets executed, then we should take care of that first. And yeah, it is. So Nautilus Sentoo is actually not really executed. It's probably mapped. Similarly to the to Yelp, we confined Yelp yesterday, and Yelp also mapped. I guess it is mmap, because I'll explain to you, because by default in the policy, in Fedora policy, all domains and events is a domain are allowed to read files, readable files. So for example, let's just see if we can look that up. So basically as he search a s and then my login user and then it's evince t, and then the target was what was the thing called again, a Nautilus Sentoo exactly. Let's see if that what that returns. Well, actually it doesn't return anything. So that means that it actually just gets attribute and executes. So it basically just checks for execute, nothing more, nothing less. All right, so let's get back. So it doesn't actually execute it so far. So let's copy this stuff over here and paste that into our block. And most of this stuff is pretty simple. So let's get back to our type enforcement file. Where are you? Here you are. Let's look for evince. Here we are. And then basically paste this stuff in there. So let's take care of a few things first. So we know this stuff here, this execute stuff, where are you? This one here is check exec. So let's just paste that above already, so just so that we know that we already basically looked at it. It's not an actual exec. Then basically what we're going to do first is add an attribute to this domain type. Runs Yelp. Because we know that this application runs Yelp. So now we basically at least finish the policy, took care of the policy that pertains to it running the help stuff. Okay, let's just go through this list again. It's the same stuff all over again. Most of this stuff is just generic, so let's just go through them. So for example, we have an I'll not take that one as, I'll take this one. So we have this font stuff here. We have deconf temp stuff here. We have this X server stuff here. We have this stuff here. We have this stuff here. We have this stuff here. We probably have this stuff here. This. And we have that as well. And that should probably, and there might even be more, but this at least, it should be at least usable. So, let's paste this in here. This is a lot of stuff. And then just go through it. So fonts, here we have it's reading fonts, so we can be sure that it reads fonts, so let's take care of that. And then step by step, but take it easy, no rush. So that's font, so let's remove that from our list so that the list basically gets smaller and smaller. And then take a sip of my coffee. Yeah. Now we have the deconf temp stuff. It's also common. Let's see, that's deconf temp, that's here, this stuff here. So these rules are also needed. It's something that all these domains need to be able to do. And then just remove it. Deconf temp t here, these two rules. And then there's a user temp that's also taken care of. Let's go above and see what else we have. So we have right the X server related stuff. This is also common to any program that has a graphical user interface. They all need to interface with X server, and that's basically that inherited shared memory. Or actually, it's not shared memory, it's a tempfs file, so to speak. And then it's reading the PIT file, the etm PIT file, and it's steam connecting to X server. So that's basically these boys right here, 1, 2, 3, and then you have the read write of the inherited temp fetch file, which is here. All right, let's go on to the next. So it's reading password file, wasn't it? Yeah, all these programs somehow read password file, and we might be able to basically actually deny that, but the question is, why would we want to do that? Because, well, only this program itself can do it, so it's not like a big problem, at least not in my view. But if it doesn't need it, we might be able to remove that anyways. Alright, so it's searching user home roots, and that's just obvious, and but it's actually also visible. So let's just remove that as well. And that's basically here the home roots and the user home dir. We have the fs-get attribute, and we have my login debus. So it's basically probably getting a session on the on the user bus. So let's just change that as well. Let's just change it all. Except deconf home. Yes, even deconf home key is in the mix. Let's just go through them all. I just know. These are basically some. You could make a template with all these rules because they are common. So in that sense, it's pretty straightforward to confine a graphical user application. Tconf, we have that as well, but we don't have these, but we do have the stream connecting to the session bus. We don't have the system deep, so these need to be taken care of. So we have ebus, ice out, and we have system debus d file like d. So let's take care of system debus d file like d first. Oh, here we have ibis, and here we have system d debus d. So let's take care of these first. And so basically, let's do that here. Because an ibis is also in config home. So in theory, you could basically just own it. It's actually dir. And is this about a dir though? Yeah, it's about a dir. So that's fine, but it's just not the same. And here we have it traversing system debus d for lib d. So that's taken care of as well. So let's remove those. So we have ibis config home t taken care of right now. And we have system debus d file I've been taken care of right now. This one can be straight up added. So we have login session, stream connected login session. So we can probably just leave that in right there as well. Ice out home t is reading it, but let's see what other programs do that have access to ice out. If I can find any. Looks like at this point I can't really find anyone. Here it's just reading, and so let's just keep that in the way it is for now. If something turns out up, we'll just edit that. So yeah, this take care of, but we need to take care of data home. So basically it creates some stuff in there. It creates a file. Yeah, it creates a file in there. So let's just have a look. So we'll grab create. And it's that recently used stuff. So we need to take care of that as well. So go back. Evince. Anyway, we're back at events. Now we have to look at some rules with regard to recently used. Some other stuff does that, use that as well. So we can copy that stuff over because we use nice blocks. Here we have it. So yeah. We can just take care of that. And just replace that. So that's taken care of. So that's done. So now we have the basic setup. Let's save and exit. Make it. As you module it. And then probably a good idea to just let's see what we, but probably it's a good idea to log off so that, yeah, let's just do it. I know it's probably not actually needed, but since that recently used file is created with the wrong type, I don't want any misconceptions. So we logged off, and let's just kill all. Just take. That's how it goes. Don't want any. Problems. RF, and then it's temp. Then it's pulse audio. So we're clean. Let's see if we any recent ABC denials at 1040. Oh yeah, we forgot some other stuff as well though, so let's take care of that as well before we get ahead of ourselves. So till and 400 for our log messages, and then just pipe that into outer to allow, because we know it stream connects to the session bus, so we know that it's actually chatting to some stuff. And seems that Yelp is also now also all of a sudden chatting more than I expected. So let's just copy this, and maybe we just added that already, not sure. Let's first do Yelp. So Yelp, do we have some debussing Yelp GVFSD? No, not really. Let's just do Yelp first. So I'm just going to paste that in here and remove this stuff for now, and then just take care of these. That sucks though, so I have to type that in. If I copy then I'll lose my buffer. My login user Yelp T. My login user Yelp T. And the same for this one. My login user Yelp T. So that's happening. It's basically deep chatting, and I've obviously overlooked that for some reason. So let's get back to our actual project at hand. So yeah, let's just paste this all the way below here, paste it in, and then just do this, only this stuff. So it seems it doesn't actually get service on the user bus, session bus, but it does chat to the user. But it's one way when it comes to, and maybe basically we haven't done anything yet, so may well be that it actually does get service on the session bus, but we just don't see it yet because it's not trying to do it yet. So please don't mind the background noise. Some folks are working hard. Not me though. Well, I'm working hard as well, but not doing this stuff that these boys are doing outside. But it's a nice day today, by the way. It's sunny, so I have the windows open. So yeah, you get a lot of noise. Seems that tomorrow it's getting even more hotter. And I'm not so very good at warm weather though. Alright, so now we took care of the dbus related stuff. So it's chatting to GVFS, it's chatting to shell, it's chatting to settings daemon, and it's chatting to HTTP, HTTPy, HTTPoo, you know what it is. I don't know what it is though. So that's just go ahead and take care of that as well. Oh yeah, I had a not so long sleep last night. I went to sleep about 1 o'clock in the morning, and then I got woken up by these workers outside. At 9 o'clock in the morning or something like that. So I did get my 8 hours, I guess. Barely. Alright, so we loaded the policy, we cleaned up the home directory, logged out. So let's just get back in there. I run that application and just peruse a little bit. We just need to make sure that some of these files get created with the proper type so that we don't get any mislabeled files in there. So it's office. Here we have it. We have bookmarks here, so we're going to have to deal with that as well, I guess. And then you have here the Yelp stuff. Let's run Yelp. Let's see what we have. Nothing. Nothing. That's not much. Now let's just print this page. Print to file and print that to the documents there. So if all is well, it's been printed now. Let's have a look. Okay, this is not right. What is this app? What is this? What is currently? That's a track miner, the tracker shit, isn't it? Yeah, the tracker extract. So we really need to take care of that. See, then all of a sudden you get into more and more stuff. So where is tracker extract? Where is tracker extract? It's in user live. So we need to take care of that. Sorry about that, but we need to do that. So yeah, now all of a sudden we're doing something else. That's how it goes. That's how it goes, guys. TR extract. TR extract. And then just copy this. Save that. And then go to the type enforcement file. Yeah, that's how it goes, guys. New section, TR extract. And TR extract gets run by the session bus. So let's see if we have something. This is, for example, also run by the session bus. So let's copy this over and use that. Oh, not just that though. But also this stuff here. TR extracts. So let's just adjust that. So all of a sudden we are in another whole world of hurt. What I was expected. This is just stuff you need to face, no matter. Sounds like this guy is building a castle outside or something. Alright, so we took care of that. So it's also taking care of the domain transition. So it's basically a session bus daemon. So we took care of the transition, but we can now also just, we know that tracker extract does some stuff here. So let's just have a look. Bless it. See, this is all tracker extract. If you look at the com, then you'll see what actually runs it. So only the dbus daemon actually runs tracker extract, which we already took care of. But all the other stuff is just related to tracker. We have a set scheduler, tracker extract. And it's all tracker extract, tracker extract. So we can basically just out it to allow this. And just copy this stuff here over. And this is basically tracker extract stuff. So that we make it a little bit easier on ourselves. So we have deconf that's searching. So let's just copy over some stuff that's common. So it's one of search user home. But I need to. Take the right ones. So here, this is what something that it needs to do, traverse home. So I'll just start. We need to basically take it easy, don't get the don't rush now. You think, oh, let's do this quickly, let's do this quickly, but you'll make mistakes. Just need to think. Yeah, but because to be able to get to deconf, you'll need to actually traverse user home. So it's doing that deconf temp dance. Let's take care of the confident tendence. Here it is. So let's take care of that. Let's use tempter here, deal with that. We took care of that. So it's actually reading a generic file. There shouldn't be any generic files. Or, yeah, actually there is, of course. Yes, sir, there is. Yep, sir. It said that's an actual PDF that it's trying to mine. Now this here is not right. This here is TR extract actually trying to stream connect to dbus. So let's just take care of this, but then just fix that. So this is not self, it's connecting to the session bus. And this is a set scheduler. Let's put that on over there. And we have deconf home stuff, and this is also common. Here, this stuff here. Yeah, took care of that. So it's reading proc, well, that's fine. Then it's reading check minor, config home, ntr store, and yes, mine generic user home content. That's basically just a separate section, because it's probably going to read, be able to read generic dirs and stuff like that. And as for this stuff here, so you have cache, you have config, you have data, so we need to basically traverse all that crap. But where is that stuff? Gee, it sounds like I'm at the dentist or something. Like they basically filling a hole. Cavity. So yeah, data. We need to basically be able to traverse data. So let's have a look at some rules where it's traversing data. Here it is. This is traversing data. So, data, let's add this one here, and then change that, it needs to traverse data, else you cannot get to this stuff. But similarly, it needs to search this directory, because if you can't search it, then you can never get to that file that you're supposed to be getting to. So that takes care of that. Now here's also, this needs to, it's searching or traversing cache home. So let's allow it to get attributes of that dir as well. And here it's actually listing the track minor fast dir. Now, I bet that it basically wants to get attributes and search it as well. So yeah, this needs to be changed. All right. So with that said, we're going to have to start all over again. So we can't, we can't actually look at dbus yet. We know it's doing something on the session bus, but we can't actually look at it yet, because then you get a misconception. Because it was running in dbus, so we need to basically reproduce a eg logout and start this stuff all over again. Oh yeah, and don't forget to restore con that file, because else you'll be doing stuff and you'll still have the same issue. And the same goes for evince, by the way. For that evince stuff. Well, actually, sucks. Let's go to the Titan for Falcon for file. So evince was already restored, that's fine, but we didn't restore these two. User lib exec evince. just make sure that this one was relabeled because we didn't do it verbose. But it is. Alright. So yeah, we got ahead of ourselves, Ted. But if you look at the ABC denials, then you'll see that it was actually DBus running the tracker extract and not something else. So. If you can look at the comms, so for example, this is here DBus daemon actually running tracker extract, so you know that it's DBus, and DBus runs in the DBus domain, so you know you are alright. Alright, now I did. So I need to log out again and then just do this whole thing over. Just have to. And now it's hanging. Every once in a while, GDM hangs, like every 6. And this is nothing to do with SE Linux, obviously, because SE Linux currently not even in a forcing mode. But it's just a GDM bug, seems, or at least maybe it's just related to GDM and KVM or virtual machines. But it's something that I know that I'm aware of. So let's just kill all. Clear and ls alt temp the drill. Can't script it because, or at least can't script everything because, yeah, this temp file is a random. Although I could script it, I guess, but. Let's just do it manually. Look, I do this for fun. I'm not in any rush or any hurry. Although, if I'm doing this too long, then I obviously need a break every once in a while. But it's not like I'm stressed out or something like that. Just do the things the slow way. Enjoy the ride. It's like I said to the guy yesterday, if you want to do large projects like this, you really need to be able to enjoy it. Because if you do this just for the results, then you're going to probably not even finish this, because there's just no light at the end of the tunnel. There's so many applications. So you really need to be able to just enjoy writing policy and looking at what the system does, because it's not going to be finished soon, anytime soon, in a long shot, by a long shot. Let's see. Not much more, but we see that the transition has happened. But we'll clean that up later, because once we run this in enforcing mode, then it's going to crap out in 10,000 different ways, obviously. So this one is actually using a pipe to communicate. This one is a bit smarter. But now we can also have a look at, and I'll just go less this, just to less var log messages, so that I don't get confused by so here we have it acquiring service tracker. Remove session. Where is it loading policy? Yeah, that's unfortunate. Back in the old days, Dbus would send a message to var log messages when the policy got reloaded. But now that's basically after complaints of us, it's sent to audit log. The issue there is that you can't actually. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. So let's just still 12 lines or 13 lines. Or actually 15. Where's my latest till? And then just take out this as well. So yeah, it's acquiring service on the session bus. Right here. Acquiring service. And you know, communicating with the user session bus is also always one way, it's one way. Because nothing should be, no problem, program should be running in the session bus. So there's no program to basically communicate with on the user session bus. So that's why that's always one way. Or it should be always one way. If it's not one way, then you have a problem. Then you know that something is running in the user session bus, that a program is running in the user session bus. And that means that something is not really unconfined, but it's running in the user domain. And that something has gone wrong, or that you have overlooked something. So that's really something you need to be aware of. No program should run in the user session bus. So. And since there's no program is running it, so you shouldn't basically, so nothing should be chatting to you from the user session bus, unless you use it from a shell, I guess. Then, but that's not supported. I don't support that currently in my policy. Or use it from some generic script or something like that. All right. So we have this stuff. So now let's open this PDF that we created. And it's in the documents there. And open that. And then let's see what ABC denials we get with regard to that. So now we have dbus running evince again. Oh, evince daemon is this. So this is evince daemon. This is evince daemon. So we need to take care of evince daemon. It's actually ran by the session bus as well. Or not as well, but it's actually run by the session bus. So let's look at some things that get run by the session bus. This mother is run by the session bus, the tr extracts. So let's copy this over. Let's go to our evince daemon part. Where's evince daemon? Where's evince daemon? Have I been removing a lot of policy? Christ, you don't say. Oh, I've been messing up. I've been removing a whole bunch of policy. Don't say. Oh my God. Oh no. It's just a mess. Whew. I thought I'd messed up real big, but it's not the case. I thought I messed up really big. Yeah, one of these days I'm going to delete stuff inadvertently. So I really need at some point need to commit so that I can actually so that I actually have something to fall back to. Because all this work will be done in vain if I lose this stuff. But yeah, you do it for fun, so it's not like, because by now this is developed on GNOME 3.6, I think it is, and we already have GNOME 3.8, and there's just a shitload of differences between 3.6 and 3.8, so this policy won't even run on 3.8, because a lot of components have changed. for example, terminal is different. So now at least we have a transition there from DUF to evince daemon. But we have rules with regard to evince. Let's paste these below. And let's have a look. So, evince reads generic content. And we did have, didn't we? No, we didn't yet, but we have now. Read generic user home content files, enders. XCG config home t can be moved to the config part. Yeah. Here it's creating a dir in config. It's reading GTK, but it's probably let's have a look at that. Grab events and then less. TTK bookmarks actually. Yeah, this is TTK. This is all TTK related. So yeah, need to take care of that. So need to find something that actually has that TTK support. Here. And then just basically extend the events domain to deal with bookmarks. We can place that in here and then just remove this stuff here. And then just, oh yeah, this is fine. And then this is also no longer applicable, although yeah, read get attribute open, so we need a read here as well. A metadata, and it's already allowed to go to data, isn't it? Space it in here. Although it probably needs to traverse a dir, but what the heck? So now we're at a point where we should probably start doing some stuff in enforcing mode. Because we overlooked a lot of stuff, but it just doesn't show up in permissive mode, so. Just in time. Don't wanna have to let's just not get ahead of ourselves. Log out. But since we just recently added transition to evince daemon, we should probably just test it in permissive mode once more. Okay, and then ls. I'll search something recent. At 23 already. We're clean at 23. So let's log in and do this stuff all over again. But yeah, we're going to have to do all this stuff again for the evince daemon, because evince daemon is probably just also getting a service on the session bus and this and that, and see, here it is. This is a prelude. Let's just copy these two over. This is a prelude. Or prelude. So evince is reading GTK file, but I thought I already allowed that. Or is it dir? It might be dir. Yeah, it's a dir. It's reading the dir. Took care of that, and now we have evince daemon connecting to the session bus, so that means that it's going to be chatting. It's going to be chatting. So we're going to have to take a look at the for log messages again. And this is probably it. This is evince. This is evince D getting service. So let's just take all these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we had that 15, didn't we, in our buffer. So yeah, evince is chatting a lot. And evince D is chatting. But evince D is only chatting to evince. Q, let's take care of this. Evince, and I'll put this where the other deeper stuff is about, and then remove this here and remove this one, because we're going to do that on the evince daemon side, else the evince daemon side is so so empty. My tooth is starting to hurt from that sound. Oh, okay, I'll just take care of that later. I'll just want, because I need to copy this stuff over. Imagine doing this work when you have toothache. Alright, so let's just save and exit and take care of this one. So this is single direction traffic, because it's a user session bus, but this is dual traffic. This is the chatting to evince, the client, the client chatting to the server, so to speak, I guess. So now we took care of that. Let's build. That's basically all at once, not much more. So now down, let's just try this out in a forcing mode, and then all hell will break loose, because you know how it goes. Once you think you're done in permissive mode and you're going to try it in enforcing mode, you're going to open up a whole new can of worms. Alright, so let's just run se-module-db to expose hidden. And then just in the forcing mode, and then we're going to get all getting into this stuff again. Yeah, send and force. And I'll search something recent. 31 currently. And this is unrelated. This is Alex C trying to suspend my block my suspend, but I don't do suspend in the first place, so you don't have to block it. I don't do suspend. Oh, not on my desktop. Anyways, too much services running on my desktop. Evince document viewer. Well, it actually starts in enforcer mode. That's something. Less that. This looks all fine. This looks all fine. This is something I need to take care of. But if that's all, then that's not much. Whoa. Where are you? Events. File descriptor. But that's just from firing it up. Let's look at it again. It's all gravy. This one we took care of that. Now why it's not? Okay, well, let's give it the benefit of the doubt. Yeah, and the remainder seems fine. So yeah, let's try and open it. Let's just try and run the contents. So this should work. Let's print. So you can see that it's actually getting slower when you enforce. This look good. Yeah, still somehow. Oh yeah, it just doesn't show that, probably. Just forget that one. Yeah, here we have some. TR extract, and that's going to be a hell of a lot of work. Because we're going to have to reproduce. TR extract. It's extracting. It's mining my files. Ain't that about it? So we have guess home. We're taking, basically need to take care of that user home trigger. This one is obvious. So this one we can basically, we have that already. So get attribute and search. Well, I'll be damned. Because it needs to get to that content there. And then you have this data home T, but we need basically cache home T. So just add that. This is just a period cache. and we only track PDF, but there's also other formats. But I haven't tested that and shit. I leave that up to the bug reporters, to the guinea pigs. That's how it should work, but nobody's ever testing this for me, of course, or actually using it, so in practice it won't work. Alright, so we are 37. We're clean. So let's just try this one again. So, help. Let's just find some other help. Now it's taking a longer time. That's not much. That's not much. Oh, it's 0 bytes. So something ain't right. Zero bytes, that's not much. So we have this stuff related to user home too. User home to their search. Oh, actually, yeah. And then we have this, but we can ignore that. And but we have this cache home t search and get attribute. So they're all trying to search cache for some reason. Let's just also for shits and giggles try user ABC, because it seems we're overlooking something. Less far log messages. Oh shit. Oh, this is some common stuff. This is probably related to me reloading the policy that says this type becomes invalid. Weird. If it would be invalid, then it would be in labeled T. And it's not. So here we have evince and evince daemon. Did I load it into the system? Oh yeah, and yeah, there were no AFC. I'll just do it again. Close this up. What a mess. Alright. true, what have you? What have we? We have nothing. So let's just act like we ain't, we don't know. Internet doesn't have that one, but this does the graphics. Open it, look for help, because, well, we just need help. Totem, nice, preferences. Let's print that page. Print it. I call that totem. Totem PDF. Select. Print. All right. Let's have a look. So it wasn't a 0-byte file. It just displayed it as a 0-byte file, because it's actually not a 0-byte file. So let's just open it, and now it should probably show it. Yeah, now it's fine. And there we go. You have the PDF. So let's see what we have. Metadata search. That's all. And we had that metadata file, and we need to add the dir there. Where is metadata file? Oh, I added it here. So get attribute and search. We probably need to take care of bookmarks and stuff with stuff like that. So let's just try out some stuff. So let's just, I want to bookmark this. Page 1. So it's bookmarked. Do I have any related ABC denials to that? Doesn't seem to be. What other stuff do I have? Zoom in. Full screen. Seems to work. Am I actually in a force mode here? Yeah, I'm actually in a force mode. Now that's smooth. That's smooth. Rotate properties. Toolbar. Help. That's running Yelp again. It's all still gravy. Less var log messages. See if we have any debus related stuff. And we have evince chatting to less or till. And now let's call it 5. For order to allow, we have evince chatting to G session. So let's just add that. It's actually going pretty smooth now. Evince, and we need to also take care of evince preview, by the way. So yeah, yeah, make that. And now let's have a look at evince preview, what happens. But first load this up. But somehow the thumbnailer stuff doesn't seem to work. Why? Oh yeah, it does work, but it just doesn't work in these stupid file dialogues. But it will probably work as soon as I run Nautilus. But that's not for today. Okay, so what was I saying? Oh yeah, print previews. Close this one up. So oh shit. Print. Here you have the print stuff again. So basically everything that has print and it's actually not. So let's see how that looks. That sucks. This need a set of rules that relates to printing. So let's see what we have. We have evince actually creating a dir. Let's see what dir that is. And we have Yelp actually executing evince. Oh. So what we basically could do to simplify the policy probably is, because what's happening is that GNOME help runs evince and evince probably runs evince previewer. So we could probably not overkill and simply just run the previewer in the evince domain, or we could just do it the hard way and confine that separately as well. Oh, not create, grep create. Evince, and that's in config home t. Let's have a look at my server ls all z config if there's an evince dir in there. Doesn't seem to be. There doesn't seem to be an evince dir here. And let's go back. I really can't tell. Well, it must be. It must be. Because if you look, the only dir that's config home t is the root dir. See, everything else is confined. So it's actually just creating an evince dir here. It's gotta be. So I'm just going to do that and then later see if confirm that. So it's actually dir, isn't it? Yep, and it's called evince. So, fc config. Evince. And I call that evince config home t. Create that here. type evince config to classify it. And so what's happening here, let's just grab something that's similar. Something that creates something config. See that it's super hard to find someone that creates something in config all of a sudden. Data home. Don't look for something, this. When you are not looking for something, you'll be able to find it easily. But if you're looking for something, so you have it. Okay, so let's change that. Evens. Now, right, add name. Get attribute and source can be removed because we already had that from a previous one. And then it's basically creating a dir with evince config type. Yeah, evince. And then type transition from evince to evince config. But only for evince dirs. That should take care of it. See if we can reproduce this. Oh yeah, we need to allow Yelp. Oh, there's so much stuff we need to do yet. We need to allow Yelp to run evens with a domain transition. See what we have. That's 55. Not 44. Oh yeah, that's not allowed because that's not supposed to be allowed. Let's see if it actually created it. If we were actually able to reproduce it. No. Let's add a bookmark. Open containing folder. I don't want to do that because that's probably running Nautilus. save a copy. That doesn't work currently. But that should, that's also another thing that should work. Why can't I reproduce this? Annoying. Also running out of tobacco. All right. I don't know. How I am supposed to reproduce that. This doesn't work because it's trying to re-exec itself probably. Yeah, it's actually exacting itself. So that should be allowed, this one. I'm not able to get it to create that there. Added here and then execute no trans as well. Or maybe it's just mmapping. Let's have a look. But we need to take care of printing. That whole printing episode again. So all these rules, that preview stuff and all that other stuff. This all needs to be allowed. So let's just try this again. Still not allowed, so we're still looking for AVC denials. Execute no trans. Oh, actually open. And a lot of stuff. Open, read. Anything that should be done to execute. So, what's... Read. Open get attribute. Taking my time, not panicking anything. Try this again. working yet, so we need looking for execute no chance probably. Execute no chance. Yeah, it's actually running it. Alright, so let's also take care of the domain transition from Yelp to Evince. We know that's something that's happening. Oh, and that's basically in the Evince section. So rather than just shell running events, we also have Yelp. My login user Yelp T. Yelp's running events, and it should do so with a domain transition, needless to say. So that should take care of that as well. So now we have something to test. Looked like a simple app, but then it's so here we have this. So what we first we're going to try and see if it can execute itself, and that works now, and then also see if we can do this from Yelp, and then basically print and then preview. This doesn't work, but we will have some AOC denials at 12:04. Yeah, this is actually the domain transition. So we have events actually running events preview. Now we can do two things. We can either just say, okay, allow events to execute events preview, or we can do a domain transition. Now, I think it's probably better to just do a domain transition right first, and then later, if we figure out, okay, it's a bad idea, then that we can basically change that after all. So it's basically events running events preview. So let's go to events and just copy this stuff over. Then go to events preview, paste this in, and change that. And it's a little bit messy. It's a little bit messy, so I need to concentrate, or else I'm going to make stupid mistakes here. So yeah, this is probably overkill. But well. But oh well. Let's take care of that. So now we get that stuff with regard to printing. Center force one, center force zero. Let's try this out. So let's try and print. Let's see what that brings us. And we have our evince config home. And it's string connecting. And it's saving. So yeah, a lot of new stuff to take care of. Let's just do that. Let's just paste it in here. So we have connecting. So basically what we're going to do is going to look a little bit at how is a piece of shit called Yelp is dealing with that. So Yelp is also string connecting to cups and stuff like that. So Yelp. If Yelp. Where is Yelp? And then we have stuff here. So here we have stuff with regard to this stuff, and this stuff as well, and this stuff as well, and this stuff as well. Okay, let's go back to evince. Where is that stuff? And I'll paste it in here and then just sift through it. So this is that cup stuff. So this one, stream connect, var run. And this shouldn't be allowed. This is already allowed. And then we have, oh, it doesn't actually connect to the IPP port, but I guess at some point it will be. And then we have new keyring, where it's basically stream connecting to it. Reading property, random device, and then you have some temp stuff here. So basically, this first, let's just take care of this stuff here. So use a home key file. Write create. I'll write create. Yeah, that's taken care of. And write add name. Yeah, that's also taken care of. So let's just deal with this stuff here. This to do. To do. Okay, let's just start by replacing some of this stuff. So this is all common to printing. And then you'll also get other stuff that we overlooked. This is fine, but we could probably need to move that up a little bit. This can be removed. Read. Dir read. Is there a dir read? Yeah. File read open. Search. Dir search. Yeah, it's all for that. This can be removed. And this can be removed as comment. Okay, so what do we have? Oh yeah, that evince config home stuff. Let's just paste it where it's doing that stuff. Evince config here. So let's just paste it in. And just extend that. So when it comes to evince configs, you want to do this stuff. And then you can remove this one here, and then basically insert this one below. Alright, that's that. So we need to take care of this stuff here. So we're going to create a type evince empty, and this is a temp file, and it's a user temp type. And then we basically need to, so this is fine, this, but this needs to be evince empty, and then we need type transition. Empty and it's a file, and it goes from tempty to evince tempty, and we can't do name file transition because this is probably should be created with a name that is not guessable. So that should take care of that as well. And now next we need to go to Yelp again because we have some things here. Because now basically we need to do this different. So let's go back and change that. Because yeah, if you've opened that dialog box, then you'll want to be able to list stuff. So where do I have that stuff? So we're basically changing this here to the following, to basically allow it to traverse and read user home dir, and then also search and read user all user home types, which is probably a bad idea, but do it anyways. And then change this. Let's have a look. That's not much. But we also want to silently deny. Oh, and I have that. I have that. So yeah, this should be it, but probably won't build because you have some requirements. Oh, it actually does build. We had some requirements out of order. I don't do much X object manager policy writing. I did it in a few years ago, but that was in a targeted policy, and this is an MLS, and this is with poly instantiation. So he's really digging deep into this stuff, and it hasn't had much testing. So that's pretty, that sucks. All right. Let's open that previewer. So let's just print and open the previewer. So this is that previewer, it's basically, and then it, that also has a print this document. Oops, and then it craps out. So let's just look at that. We have a file rename. Copy this over as well. of dumpty stuff here. We have a file rename. And then we'll paste this in there and work our way through that as well. This is evince D, by the way. This is not where it should be. This is it. So yeah, we need to work through this as well. And also first, of course, check out and see if there's executes in there, but there doesn't seem to be any executes. So let's... Yeah, I just don't know. I can look at it for hours, but that doesn't help. Phones. I have my own business to take care of right now. Phones. Prev. Prev. Breath. Breath. That's false. And here it's basically trying to do some stuff. Okay, let's first take care of the X server related stuff. Step by step. rid of this, rid of this. Voila, G. Basically, might as well just run it in a evince domain. Probably a better idea. Probably just a better idea. Let's just do that. This is really just overkill. Although, yeah, it's kind of against my principles. And then even sprint, then it's an entry point. Entry point. Actually, let's just do that here. Yeah, he's probably annoyed by me, but if I don't know it, then I don't know it. If I am able to help, then I will help, but if I just don't know it, then might as well just shut up. We're clear. So let's just go through this again. That doesn't work. We have dbus related stuff. I'm pretty sure, or at least pretty sure. Oh, that's actually just basically. No, it's. Well, not sure what it does then. This won't work. Well, it works because we're in permissive mode. So you have dump, but it's not even. We shouldn't look at this stuff. We're just going to have to log out and clear the system. Because we're getting ahead of ourselves. Kill all. I can get to it. So it's clear. And let's just try it out. So it was in permissive mode, so the reason that it crept out is just probably the way it works. That wasn't a lot. I'll fail to create directory. So it's creating a directory. But a lot of this stuff is not applicable. But this one here is is this one here. Time to dir events. So it's creating a dir. All the way below, we already have that type, but so there we need to basically write remove name, search, get attribute, write, create, unlink, open. Attributes, well, add name, remove name, search, get attribute, and then we have a file editor. The weird thing is, why is that actually, I thought I, oh yeah, that's actually module DB. That should probably be, okay, so let's try that again. Not sure. Yeah, now it's safe. Let's see if we have anything else. Yeah, these are unrelated. NC module D. This is not gonna work. This is going to execute Nautilus Center. And this is gonna execute Nautilus, which is not allowed. And this is going to execute Nautilus Center, not allowed. So yeah, it's okay. This should be it. At least it should be something. So it's trying to execute. Oh, you have a RM there, yeah, that I need to allow. And here, evince is trying to relabel. Can you believe that? Let's first take care of that other. Can you believe it? Evince is trying to do Azure Linux administration. So I'll just silently deny that because, well, we can't have that obviously. Grab reload from this EV job scheduler. You can't have none of this stuff. So this is going to be silently denied. Alright, so this is probably about it. It's not perfect, but we dealt with a lot of issues. But yeah, it's not perfect. So, I'll search. ACTS recent. Actually, 1245. Audit to allow. We're clean. Let's all Z home. My login. User. And then config. We have events. Contents. And let's all see temp. Here we have events content that's it wasn't allowed to render, so it wasn't allowed to remove it, so that's why we see it. But you see it's classified. So yeah, that's cool. And here you have yell temp file that also for some reason wasn't unlinked. Same here. But at least it's all classified. Alright. So we were clean, so let's do just one more run. Go to Repix, open it. Go to... Actually, let's open a file. Open this one here. Opened up. Print, but let's print preview. Here's the preview. Add a bookmark and actually save a copy again. No, we have more setting extended attributes. Oh, but a lamer. What a lamer. So you're kidding me. Is that file not saved? Oh, that's lame. But it's safe. It's just crying. So basically what it's saying is I can't set the extended attribute security as in Linux. And that's basically the relabel stuff. That's basically the relabel stuff that it's crying about. See, no matches. Was trying to basically probably use ZFS create con, or basically trying to chcon or restore con after it created the file, and it wasn't able to, so it decided to be to sound sophisticated. And well, it's actually important if you deal with multi-level security. And then you won't be able to classify it properly, then you have a big problem. But then again, it did save it. It just gave a message that it wasn't able to set the SELinux context, reset the SELinux context. But it did actually save it. So yeah, smart ass. But not smart enough in my view. Alright, So yeah, that's basically it. So we got Nautilus now also. It's a little bit of a hacky way, because, well, I just basically ran the previewer in the main Nautilus domain, because, well, the both of these processes have a lot in common, so it wasn't really a good idea to just run them in separate domains, because, well, that would be just much more policy, and for no apparent reason, for no compelling reason, so to speak. So yeah, so we have one, at least one more functionality, but actually that's more functionality, because you have to do that tracker thing and some other stuff, I think. So there's evince in the evince domain. So confine, so if evince is compromised for some reason, so if you basically click a malicious PDF or something, I don't know how that works, but then basically it's confined. Now, what does that mean? So it can actually just mess with your generic files, so because it should be able to basically save and read generic files. But we're not targeting generic content, we're targeting content that is not generic. And with that regard, so for example, your evince won't be able to read your GNOME keyring, won't be able to read your SSH keys, won't be able to read your GPG keys. And that's the protection that we're trying to achieve. So, but that's where people often get confused. They want to protect their generic content, but that's just an oxymoron. If you want some content to be protected, then you need to use a private type and not use a generic content type. But you shouldn't basically label content that's supposedly shareable with a private type. So like your file, so for example, you have this PDF now in your home directory, and let's say you want to mail it out, then your mailer needs to be able to read it. Or let's say you're receiving a PDF in the mail and you're saving that attachment, then you need to, and then even need to be able to read that once the attachment is saved. So the idea is that some of this stuff is just shareable, it should just be shared across various domains. So that's basically why I'm actually why I actually decided to do this. Well, I won't show you here all of it, but why I basically I'm classifying stuff like this the way it is, and that's why this is generic content, because it's supposed to be generic content. So yeah, that's it for this chapter. I'm glad this one is over, but the next one is going to be Nautilus, which is a bitch, so to speak. That's a suite. You have Nautilus send to, you have Nautilus connect server, you have Nautilus auto run, you have Nautilus, and then you have Nautilus running all kinds of thumbnailers. So if you have basically, so that's just pretty messy. So that's probably for another day. I don't think I'm going to deal with that today. I've had enough stuff to deal with today. All right, so that's it. Log out. And there we go. Bye bye.